my god.
Yeah, boy.
Hi sneakies, it's me, Fifi, and I'm back again today with another couple of reaction for you guys, and this is my album first listen for Love Struck. Now, if you missed my reaction to the title track and MV, Giddy, you can go over and find it in my Kepler playlist on my channel, along with all my other Kepler reactions. I have reacted to all their music content, I believe, full of Kepler music content. Wow, I'm really great at like promoting my own stuff. So this is the album first listen, okay? And it's gonna consist of the B-sides, I'm assuming that's Lovely, Back to the City, Why, and Happy Ending. I'm super, super excited. Let's just go. Okay guys, just quickly before we start, quick disclaimer, I'm gonna be doing lyric videos today simply because I feel like I'm not that aware of who's singing, like I don't really know the members that well or anything like that, so I'm choosing to do lyric videos today. I am aware that these lyric videos are sometimes wrong. If there's a mistake, simply just correct it in the comments. No need to complain and blow, this is wrong. If there's a mistake, just let me know what it is in the comments. Also, I will be reading the lyrics as they're there, however, I won't be concentrating on them, so please don't expect some sort of lyrical analysis. Let's go. The first B-side is LVLY, Lovely, Lovely, I'm not sure, let's go.
L-O-V-E-L-Y, Lovely,
L-O-V, I love that voice manipulation. Is it voice manipulation? Melodies. This reminds me of something. That's about 400 different beats within this song. It's a guitar that sounds so nice.
This
pre-chorus.
It's
an electric guitar in the back, I think. That beat right there. absolutely loved that. That was brilliant. It was quite experimental, but in a very sort of Kepler way. I loved the constant beat changes. I wouldn't call them switch-ups, because they weren't too like out there in terms of a switch-up. Do you know what I mean? It wasn't like, oh, a complete 180. I felt like it was sort of beat changes, slight changes within the instrumental, but the vibe, like, it remained very sort of consistent. The song was very cohesive. There weren't like constant switch-ups. And I feel like Kepler are really good at making songs in that sense. For me, that's kind of Kepler's sound since the beginning. I felt like they'd combine beats changes, not switch-ups, different sounds within a song, but not in like an Esper way. Do you know what I mean? Not like in an SM sort of way. It was more or like an N-mix, mixed pop sort of way. It was always very sort of subtle combination of sounds, and that was a perfect example of it. For me, that was very much a Kepler sort of sounding song. I loved it. I loved the constant beat changes. I love the some of the instrumentation. Some of the instrumentation was very, very interesting. I wasn't sure if it was synths, if it was voice manipulation. Either way, it sounded brilliant. At some point, I think I had electric guitars. At some point as well, that one specific beat switch up, you know the one I mean, the one, I think it was in the post-chorus, where it switches up for a little bit, it sounds like live, like my proper drums, and then it goes back into that sort of spicy beat. I loved that part a lot. The pre-chorus was absolutely stunning, really nice chords, really nice melodies all throughout. Fantastic, I love that. Let's go on to the next one. Okay guys, let's go. Next up, we have Back to the City. This is gonna be an 80s synth pop throwback. Whoa, very pretty melody. Very bored of this sound, but we're gonna listen to it objectively. Very pretty. Ooh, love the electric guitar there. Breaks in the beat. That chord progression is stunning. Oh, very catchy. Yeah. very, very good song. It was very, very well produced, very well written. That's a bit of a tongue twister. Very well written. Oh my God, guys, try and say it really quickly. Very well written. Very well written. Oh my God, it's very well written in terms of like melodies. Really, really sweet and nice melodies. I actually really enjoyed the pre-chorus part. That part was very, very pretty. There was a specific chord progression in that that just sounded so nice. I love those synths. I love those pads there. I'm bored of this sound though. If you're subscribed to me, you watch my other reactions, you know I'm sick to death of 80s throwback synth pop sounds and 70s disco. I'm just done with it. I actually had someone ask me, say, well, why aren't you bored of, like, say, R&B, or why aren't you bored of hip-hop? It's because what you need to understand is, with these throwback songs, to get a throwback sound, you have to use the same instrumentation, the same structure, the same... It's the same sounds all the time. And it gets boring because, as well, like... I listen to music from the 80s. Like, I grew up listening to lots of music from the 80s and 70s because of my dad. So I've been listening to this sound my whole life, and it's the same instruments, the same drum pads, the same exact synths. In the 80s, you didn't have this huge variation of electronic sort of sounds and synths. It would be the same shit over and over and over and over. So when you get these throwback songs, they sound very, very similar because you have to use a specific instrumentation to make these songs, right? That's why I get so bored of like the 70s disco and 80s synth pop compared to like other genres. Do you know what I mean? It's because this is a very specific sound. Saying that, if you're not bored of that sound, that song was brilliant. Like, if I'd heard that earlier on when K-pop wasn't, where every single group wasn't doing this sound, I would have probably enjoyed it a lot more. But the song was good. I'm just bored of that sound personally. Let's go on to the next one. Okay, guys, let's go. Next up, we have the track Why. Fender Rhodes. That's Fender Rhodes. Woo! When I say perfect, I mean perfect. That was my vibe. That is making it into my all-time favorite couple of songs list. For sure, for sure. That might come in third. Might make its way even closer to the top eventually. This is just my first time hearing it, but it's going probably top three Kepler songs ever, okay? That was absolutely fantastic. As soon as I heard those Fender Rhodes, I was like, yeah. Yeah, this about to slappity-slap that dum, dum, dum. The instrumentation, there was that one specific synth. That synth always sounds so good. Always sounds so good. The beat, the melodies, really nice sweet melodies, really nice ad-libs. That whole thing was a 10 out of 10 for me. 10 out of 10, snakery. I'll say it, snakery. You snake me, Kepler snake me, snakery. Let's go on to the next one. Okay guys, let's go. Next up we have the track Happy Ending. I was about to make a joke, but I made a joke yesterday. And it went over so many people's heads. Let's go. Happy Ending, Kepler. What? What? What the hell is happening? My god, this is about to be my summer. This is about to be my summer bop. Oh, this is so good. This chorus reminds me of GWSN, Gonggon Sonya. Fight me and I will fight back. But that is my favourite Kepler song. That is literally my favourite Kepler song. I said the last one might have to make it. That is it. That has beaten everything. That has beaten everything thus far. I love that so much. Immediately, it reminded me of the previous track. There's little bursts that bloom, bloom. So in the previous one, there's little bursts with Fender Rhodes. This time it was guitar, guys. If you can hear some loud noises, it is my tortoise. She's trying to escape. She's trying to escape from her little... I have her kind of locked in behind the couch and I put like a little gate thing so she can't... Because she goes around wreaking havoc if I don't, whilst I'm filming. Usually I let her out once I stop. But anyway, absolutely brilliant.
Stamada!
Sorry guys, I just had to go and move her, she's too annoying. That was a 10 out of 10 snakery for me. Anyway, back to the little bloom, bloom, bloom. That was so good. Bro, the away, 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 oh. That melody, that was, I think that's my favorite part of the whole song. Like, I love every single thing about that song, but I think it was a away, 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 away. So guys, I have to keep getting up, she's really doing my head in. I loved how mellow the verses were and almost quite jazzy. Like, you had those little jazzy bursts of guitar, like, do you know what I mean? And then the chorus was quiet, it was groovy, it was dancey, it had a rhythm, it had a little step to it. Oh, like I said whilst I was listening, the chorus did kind of remind me a little bit of GWSN, Gong Gong Sonia. I think it's Girls in the Park, the English, I think I was just gonna go on Sonia. Anyway, it reminded me of them a little bit in that chorus, and that sound just suited them so well. Also, they sounded extra good. Every single member sounded extra good on that for some reason. Their delivery, like their tones, just sounded extra good, and the way they were delivering their lines, kind of just a little bit more sort of laid back, it just sounded extra good. I'm obsessed, that's my favorite Kepler song of all time. Honestly and truly, happy ending indeed. Let me know your favorite track on this album. I think it's pretty clear which one's my favorite. Happy ending. Let me know which track is your favorite. And yeah, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up if you didn't like it. Subscribe if you haven't subscribed. If you have subscribed, I love you. Go follow me on Instagram, guys. Go follow me on Twitter. And yeah, goodbye.
Oh!